congratulate every class other than the G1s for loading their slides in advance.
My bad.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey guys, how's it going? There's quite a lot of you. So we're the G1s. And we were at Harvard, but now we're going to transfer to Stanford after our first final exam. So we decided, kind of based on the feedback that we had gotten, that we wanted to put together a presentation to kind of give back to the econ department after we've gotten so much. And a lot of this, you know, there's been a lot of talk about making the department a lot friendlier to graduate students. So we have the G1 Happiness Committee, and someone lovingly brought one of our plants that we bought. It really brings the green man. So you're welcome for that. But in addition to that, we wanted to invite compile a lot of the advice that we've gotten, both good and bad, and share it with the department, because we've all gotten, you know, varying amounts of, or just kind of varying bits of advice, so we'd like to collate that and give it back to more than just us. We think it'll be useful to people going on the job market or second years and stuff like that. So, we'll take our private information and make it public. And so we're just going to kind of go in the line and then share some of our favorite information with you guys. So please enjoy.
So, friends. You must know your friends because you'll learn as much from your fellow students as from faculty. But you also have a time budget constraint. So you need to ask with my the answers to both of these questions are no. Then question yourself whether it's optimal to learn their names.
We learned a lot this year about maximizing utility. And we've learned that also.
Hold the mic closer.
Okay, better? This year we've learned a lot about maximizing utility. We've learned that that means maximizing our job market prospects. And so we need to always be working. And sometimes there are also other things we need to be doing. Like, what if you gotta stand? Well, then get a standing desk. If you gotta run, then treadmill desk. If you gotta poop. That really academia is a game and that you should be looking for as much credit as possible, which is really a zero-sum game. And so we learned this from from Justin Wolfers mostly. Women, you should be co-authoring with women or solo authoring, and men, well, be strategic.
Yeah, so among many of the advice that you guys gave us, there was definitely something about kids. So before coming here, many of us thought about getting to this risky business of families, but so let's be serious. Now, if you really want to think about this, you gotta write them all. He's at number one, I guess. Let's not be foolish. Model our big FOC monster here. And of course, trivially, the optimal number of less than
so
we also learned about the holiday skip. And it's important to keep in mind with these things that there's limited upside and unlimited downside. you really want to treat these things like a presentation, you know? Be professional, dress very nice. Actually, you forgot to give the G1s that memo this year. and really with these things, you know, people hardly ever remember the good ones, but they often remember the bad ones. Circa 2014. People won't even tell us what you guys said.
What happened?
Next up, teaching. As we all know, we have to teach in order to get our stipend, which is terrible. It takes away from our time to do research. So, to be a good TF, or actually just to be a good researcher, idolize your laziest TF. Do exactly what they do. So, should you attend lectures? No. You should instead be doing research. Do you want to write solutions to problems? No, just use the ones from last year, then fine. Prepare material for section. Just improvise. They can handle it. And weekly office hour? Here's a tip. If you call your students, they won't come. Be the anti-art hero. Seriously, his notes are way too good.
So, of course, the most valuable asset we have in this department is faculty. So for students, what we do use them, right? We have amazing faculty. But don't wait too long. Because if you wait too long, you will hear or you will send an email and say, huh.
So we've gotten a lot of advice from Professor Leibson, and I'm sure many of you have gotten some of the same. And if you haven't, we've basically summarized it as this, that one of the things you really want to be doing in your first year is going on the job market. I mean, if you get to the end of your first year and you don't have at least 3 job offers, then you really have to ask yourself, what have I been doing? I mean, have you been vacuuming? Have you vacuumed your own apartment? I once vacuumed my own apartment in first year, and it was the stupidest thing I ever did. I didn't go on the job market for a whole nother year.
Okay, so a few more advices on how to write your paper. And as you know, no one reads beyond your introduction, so you have to learn how to be concise. In fact, no one reads the whole introduction. Why? I mean, I have some empirical evidence on that. But in fact, it's even worse. No one reads more than the first sentence. You really have to be concise. And in fact, I mean, cite Vedas for your job market paper was take Vedas to BuzzFeed. So, and well, you also need to like pull up a few ideas from like the box of ideas and not to be afraid to reject the one that had low variance. And you have to maximize the number of pros. So I mean like tons of people publish in AR but landed on the job market.
So time is a scarce resource, as we know. And to be honest, the reading lists are a bit long for the first 3 courses. I've compensated by not reading a single paper. But I think in order to optimize, you should at least pay attention to the previous research when kind of designing your own research agenda. So you really have to optimize those. So you should skip, you know, don't read, unless you really hate the paper. Then you have to read really closely. And what you really want to do is just, you know, request the data. Because, you know, some people aren't so good at checking these sorts of things. And then we end up in a lot of trouble. But the great thing is that you get tons of sites for finding issues in other people's papers. But overall, you know, you really shouldn't be afraid to cite papers. everyone does it all the time. Lucor has like something like 22 sites or something like that. And if you ever feel really guilty about it, don't worry, because no one's reading your
So another thing we've learned in our first year is that it's very important to dress well. Style. This is really a false dichotomy, and we have a lot of role models here in the department. You can dress like Ed, who dresses kind of like Al Capone's lawyer. You're a little baggy, it's a bit out of style. You can dress like David, but it seems like he's boycotting the Irish. You can dress like Professor Maskin, whose style is perhaps best described by the phrase Maskin monotonous. But if you win the Nobel Prize, you get to dress however you want. And what about the female faculty? Wait, what female faculty? We'll let you know.
Wow, thanks guys, that was great. So that was a lot of information, which kind of sums up the first year of graduate school. You just get a ton of stuff thrown at you, and then you have to regurgitate it at the end of the year, or you guys kick us out. So I just want to quickly summarize kind of the bullet points in case you guys want to study up on this later, you know, since it was so useful. So you got your friends, you want to manipulate them to maximize your job market prospects. You have utility, maximize, obviously. Co-authors, you know, chicks before dicks. kids, negative. Skips, never do this. This is a terrible idea. And if you do apologize, I'm incredibly sorry. Teaching, of course, want to minimize that. Advice, I guess it's useful to give it. Number of offers, you know, you really, really shoot for free by the end of the first year on this. Why are you here? The first sentence is like extremely important. What you're writing is so important. And we told us time and time again that you have like a really great research idea, but if your paper isn't good, no one's gonna care. So you really wanna, you know, master the first sentence. Again, they're only going to read the first sentence, so you really need a major audience. Really, really important. Options, of course, you know, as many draws as possible. Of course, you don't need to read sparingly. Well, and most importantly,